Hello! This video is meant to be a basic overview of the functions and capabilities of the Cisco Touch 10 touch panel and its respective system. Please note that not all functions and capabilities found on this touch panel may be found in every room outfitted with a Touch 10 system. There may be some differences between this touch panel and the touch panels found in your respective rooms. Camera controls. Before we begin, notice how the home screen of the Touch 10 touch panel changed. This will occur when the system is in a call. We will be showcasing the functions and capabilities of the touch panel while in a call. We will begin by going over the camera controls found in the upper right-hand corner of the Touch 10 screen. It is marked with a camcorder icon. When pressed, the camera menu will appear. Here, you will have the ability to do the following. You can change the selected camera by selecting the down arrow, then selecting which camera you would like to use. You can move the selected camera by using the directional arrows and zoom controls. You can enable speaker or presenter track. Presenter track locks the camera on the professor in the front of the room and allows the camera to track their position as they move across the room. Speaker track locks the camera on a talking student and zooms in to let others see who is speaking. This turns manual camera control into automatic camera control. To enable this, simply press the corresponding button. To turn this feature off, simply reselect the button. You can enable the self view from your camera feed to remain on the screen. When the camera menu is open, a self view window will appear on a TV screen within the room, allowing you to better position and track your camera movements. To keep this feature turned on after the camera menu is deselected, simply check the indicated box. You can then return to the home screen, where you can hold and drag the self view to your desired location. When you are finished using the camera menu, and with all other menus and screens on the Touch 10, to return to the home screen, simply press any gray area outside the menu or screen. Layouts. Next, you can find the Layouts option located just to the right of the camera icon in the upper right-hand corner of the Touch 10 screen. When pressed, a small menu will appear along the top of the screen. You can then select how the incoming video from other sites will appear on the back monitors of the room. You can select them by simply opening up this menu, then selecting which layout you would like to use. The menu will automatically close after making the selection. Screen sharing. One of the main features that the Touch 10 allows is the ability to share content from within a call. You can enter the Share Screen menu by selecting the Share button. Here, you can select what source to share. While in a call, simply find what source you would like to see, such as the PC, and select the green Share button. To stop sharing, press the Stop Sharing button. If you are not part of a call, a similar button called Preview will appear. Using this will show the content on the screens in the room, but not within a call. Once you have selected your source to share, simply press the gray X located in the upper right-hand corner to return to the home screen. While sharing content, the Share button will have changed to a blue color, indicating that the system is currently sharing content. Some of the buttons along the bottom will have moved locations, with some of them moving to the More button. We will go over these buttons now. Room controls. The Room controls button will take you to a menu that allows the user to control different aspects in the room. The first tab is the Displays tab. This is where you can turn on and off the projector and TV monitors found within the classroom. You can also find the projector mute button, which is used to mute the projector's feed without turning it off. This is useful if the instructor wants to show something in the front of the classroom without the projector light blinding them. Please note that the projector mute button only mutes the projector in the room. It does not stop sharing content with other participants in the call. Next is the camera focus tab. This allows the user to turn on and off the camera's auto-focusing capabilities. Simply select which type, auto or manual, you would like to use. Please note that this only affects the instructor camera and not the student camera, even if the student camera is selected. The Doc Cam tab is where you will control the document camera's zooming, as well as some other added features, such as presets and a laser target. As a reminder, the Doc Cam tab only allows users to control the ceiling-mounted document camera in the room. The controls found on this tab will not work if your room features only a desktop document camera, where manual control and zooming is required. The Shade Screen tab, if available, is where you can lower and raise different screens found within the room, such as the projector screen and shades and blinders for the windows in the room. Finally, the Reset tab is where you will find pre-programmed reset buttons to help troubleshoot some common issues that may arise while using the Touch 10 system. Please do not use these buttons unless given permission from a lead facilitator or from your campus's supervisor. Microphones. The Microphones button will take you to the menu that controls the student microphones. There is only a simple button that allows the user to mute and unmute the student microphones. If the button is blue, that indicates that the student microphones are muted. If the button is gray, this indicates that they are unmuted. Monitors. The Monitors button takes the user to a menu where they can select a few different options for the monitors in their classroom. On the first tab, labeled Monitors, users can select the option of Combine or Split. Simply put, this can change how content and video from other sites is viewed in the classroom. If Combined is selected, it will combine both the video of the remote participants and the content being shared onto one screen. If Split is selected, it will split the feeds between the monitors available in the room. While split, users can select the Swap Monitors button, which will flip the sources between each monitor to the other. The Main Video tab allows you to choose what source you want to be your camera feed. Normally set to camera, you can manually change this in certain situations. This feature is used when showing high-quality videos or motion pictures in a broadcast environment with other sites. By making the shared content source the main source, it increases the frames per second and quality of the outgoing video. You can also select which form of content you are sharing while using the main source. Sharpness is best for things like PowerPoint presentations and Word documents, creating a sharper and more clear image. Motion is for videos and other captured motion, creating a better quality picture that is less likely to lag or skip. Volume and the All Mute. Located on the outside of the Touch 10 touch panel, there are three physical buttons. The first two buttons allow the user to raise and lower the volume in the room. The final button is called the All Mute. This acts as a master mute button, which allows audio and sound to be sent through the system and through the computer. When the button is red, that means that sound is stopped, the All Mute is muted, and no sound from your microphones or content will be shared. When the button is green, that means sound is a go, the All Mute is unmuted, and the sound will be shared. Zoom controls. Finally, a feature that has been included in the Touch 10 system is the capability to connect up directly to a Zoom call. You can directly call out to the Zoom meeting by selecting the Zoom button on the Touch 10 home menu. You will then be asked to enter in the meeting ID, passcode, and the host key if applicable. Once all the necessary information is entered, the room will automatically connect to the call. Notice how the home screen of the Touch 10 while in a Zoom call looks very similar to that of the home screen when in a broadcast call. All of the functions previously discussed are available during a Zoom call. You will also have access to the Zoom Controls button. The first tab of the Zoom Controls button has features and controls that allow the user to manipulate certain aspects of the Zoom call. These include things such as showing chats on the TV monitors, showing non-video participants, changing the video layout, and unmuting the room system in Zoom. These are basic controls that anyone can have access to while being a part of any Zoom call. The Host Controls tab features a variety of controls that only those who entered in their host key and are hosting the meeting can use. These features include starting and stopping recordings and muting all participants. There is also a feature that will allow you to enter in the host key if you did not enter it in previously. With that said, these are the basic controls and functions found on the Touch 10 touch panel system. Please remember that each touch panel is unique in its own right, and that some of the functions that have been reviewed in this training video may not be available where you are, or they may be in a different spot. Please contact your location's technician or supervisor for help, or visit classroomsupport.usu.edu to request training if you need additional help or if you have any questions. Thank you so much, and have a wonderful day.